Hi. Recently, I've been dealing with a few heated debates over the viability of Medic in SAS4, and I thought it'd be a good time to take a break from trashing Medic to show a good side of it. The low-level LMS Medic idea has been around for a while due to it theoretically being simple and effective, but as far as I know, it's never been properly tested before, so I decided to give it a run on every map in the game and record every first attempt. Out of the around total of 10 games I've played, I haven't lost a single one, even if it's stretched out to around 10 minutes, so I can at least somewhat confirm that this build is really good at what it does. As for the actual build and idea behind it, the one issue LMS players face is it being the most annoying event to grind into the time requirement caused by bosses spawning at a bit above 9 minutes, making it extremely easy for any moderately geared player to live that long. This means that 5 or less points could take you 10 plus minutes of playtime, which is a huge investment, so we're trying to mitigate that by playing on a level that has the highest chance of matching the people that will die as early as possible. Then we're scaling movement and medkit, so we don't have to shoot almost the entire match usually, and also so we can hoard mobs towards players and avoid their attacks effectively while not caring whether we take some hits. This build will still work even if you're not good at avoiding damage, although some level of competency is required for a decent win rate. Anyway, now that that's out of the way, enjoy the rest of the gameplay.
Thank you.
All right, so I'm gonna do a quick rundown of the items I used. Basically, I've decided not to reroll anything. I've used natural drops that I got while I was leveling to level 16. All but one item was gotten below level 16. So basically, we have on the helmet, you want to prioritize revitalizing. I did get pre-augged body fueling, which is the ideal second augment. So you want a high-grade helmet. Ideally, it can come with base movement. If it doesn't, that's also fine. Don't use anything with a penalty, of course. It'll ruin the build. For the West, pre-aug fortified. Second aug was body fueling, which is ideal. Fortified is not bad on this as a medic because, well, it did give me like 10% resistances, and it's great. A grade 5. I didn't even bring it up to 7. So it's a pretty nice improvement, you know, nothing special, but it does give me some resistance. As for the gloves, you want nimble. If you can find a power assist or gloves with movement, or maybe even reload, that's ideal. But I would go with movement over reload on this build specifically, because it doesn't really shoot much. You only shoot if you're about to die or you need to take care of a problematic mob. Otherwise, you're pretty much chilling. You know, you're running and dodging, trying to kill your teammates. Not really much shooting going on because that helps people stay alive for longer, obviously. Pants, it's gonna be again, you're gonna wanna look for something with movement speed. I have grade 7 machine assisted in augment the fire, it's not really good. You don't need to waste cash and something like that. Fortified is always good because it does give you a bit of resistance to the most common damage type, but like fire really isn't worth augmenting in my opinion. Then for the boots, I had the option. This was clean, so I would either go machine assist or revitalizing. I decided revitalizing was a lot more important. You do want to have somewhat spammable med kits, otherwise you will pretty much be a bit fucked in some scenarios. But movement is also good too, although this gives me almost 2 per second, which is about like I think 45% of my total energy regen. So as I had movement points in my skills, I decided this is the optimal augment to use. The probably the most valuable piece other than a power assist you can have is boots with two augment slots, grade 10, because then you can roll both machine assist and revitalizing, which pretty much almost on its own, or I would say on its own, gives you enough movement speed and energy regen to run this build on their own. So you do want to look out for that. Other than that, in terms of weapons, we're using stuff that we dropped while leveling as well. This was dropped on level 2. It's basically a 0% penalty gun, the best one that I dropped, and it's pretty trash, but you know, it gets the job done. It can stun mobs, it can kill, it can kill, you know, not fast, but it gets the job done usually. I've dropped the Raptor somewhere along the line of playing Last Man Standing. It's basically my DPS, deals a lot more than Phantom. The reason I'm using two is because it has a slight penalty, which can sometimes slow you down enough for mobs to catch up. And also because we don't run reload on this build at all, so you want to have at least two weapons so you can switch while you're reloading if you're dying or something. And basically that's it for the gear. You know, you can run this build with shit you find while leveling. It's pretty budget friendly, to be honest. It's a cheap build.